Welcome back to my channel. My name is Kimberly, also known as Mvali. Thank you so much for tuning in. Before we get started, I just want to introduce you to a little something that is new onto our channel, and that is an intro. A girl has got an intro now. I'm so excited. For your viewing pleasure, my intro, ladies and gentlemen. Like, how cute is it? How cute is she? We are all introed up, honey. Anyway, let me just welcome you guys back here again. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you are a new subscriber, welcome to my channel, and thank you so much for clicking on this video. To you guys that have joined the family, that are very, very new to the family, I appreciate you so much. And for all the regular subscribers that have been here since, welcome back, Umdazi. I really do love the fact that you all are tuned in. So, in today's video, what I'm going to be doing is having a nice little chat with you guys regarding powder. And I put up a question box up on Instagram asking you guys if you have any powder concerns or any powder questions, because I knew I was going to create a video where I actually discuss all my favorites in powder. I did get a couple of questions, and I'm going to try and, as I talk through the powder, try and address all of your concerns. But if there's anything that I'm not going to be addressing in this video, do feel free to leave it in the comment section down below. So without any further ado, let us get straight into the video that is all about the powder. Right, so speaking about powder, I know it is not really a touchy subject, but it is a subject that can get a bit confusing when it comes to makeup. And I think it's something that we really need to discuss, because it's very, very important. It gives your makeup the kind of look that you want to go for and make sure that your makeup lasts. So speaking about powder is definitely worth it. But before we get into powder, get into my favorites, or my top four favorites that I have for powder, I just want to discuss the difference between a setting powder and a finishing powder, because I know that is something that we struggle with. So a finishing powder is basically a powder that will blur you, that will finish off your makeup, that makes everything just look nice and airbrushed and blurred. And then a setting powder is a powder that is used to set your creams and your makeup in place. There's definitely a difference between the two, and the main difference between the finishing powder and the setting powder is that a finishing powder actually is not designed to set your makeup. It's not designed to ensure the long wear of your makeup. That would be a setting powder. Now, I know many a times, without you realizing even, you might have used a finishing powder in order to do the job of a setting powder, and sometimes you might not have been happy with your makeup. The makeup might not have lasted a very long time, or if you're like me, you might have used the finishing powder to set your makeup and you didn't really notice the difference because you only wore your makeup for a very short period of time. Okay, so I'm gonna go straight into my top four powders, and then straight after that I'm gonna address some of the concerns that you guys have regarding powder. All right, you guys, so I'm gonna start off with my high-end powders. So I have four powders that I'm gonna be speaking about today. So two are high-end powders and two are the more affordable drugstore powders. The first powder that I'm gonna be talking about is my favorite powder, and that is the Huda Beauty powder, and this is in the shade Banana Bread. So this is my favorite powder currently, and I think it is really great for like full coverage makeup looks. If you have a full coverage concealer, this would probably be the best powder in my opinion to set the full coverage concealer with, because a lot of the times, or the other powder in this category that I'm going to be talking about, doesn't really do well with setting full coverage concealer. So one thing about this powder, it will make sure that you are blurred. I wish I had like demo clips, but it would have taken forever to release this video if I did demo clips. But this powder, one thing that I noticed about the powder from the first time that I used it, that the minute that I sit with the powder, and I don't use a lot, I basically take my powder on a brush and I tap the powder into my skin. As you guys would have seen in my previous tutorials, that's how I handle powder. And the minute I applied this powder, I could see the blur. I could see that it was full coverage. It literally did the job. I really also love the color of the powder. It is in the shade Banana Bread, so it's not too yellow, which I really, really like. We prefer translucent powders over color powders, and this one over here is perfect for that because it's not too yellow. It's a bit toned down and works perfectly with my skin. And again, like I said, it is the powder that I'm wearing today. If you are someone that is more on the dry side, I'm not sure this powder would be perfect for you because it is quite drying. It's not drying in a really bad way, but I can feel it on my skin as it dries, especially if you pack on the powder a lot. But one tip that I can give you perhaps is to not take the powder on like maybe a sponge, or you can take it on a sponge, but you just tap off the excess powder. And even when you're using a brush, just tap off the excess powder and just take the powder, and instead of baking, just set the powder lightly underneath your eye, and it really does the job. I know it's called the easy bake powder, but you don't have to bake with it to get the absolute best results out of this powder, which I really, really like, honestly. Okay, so the next powder that I have that is a high-end powder is the Laura Mercier translucent powder. So I do know that Laura Mercier has extended the range in this powder, and they have given like shades like honey and so on for the more deeper tone. But I prefer, like I said, I prefer translucent powders as opposed to powders that have color pigment in it. And this really works well for me as well. Again, it does give a blurring like airbrush effect and look underneath the eyes. But I wouldn't say that the coverage in this powder is really full like the Huda one. The Huda one, you really feel the coverage, and it would probably work very well with a full coverage concealer, whereas this doesn't provide that. It's more for like your natural type of finish. If you do want to go glam, Huda is your girl. But if you don't want to go glam, you want to go toned down, but you also want to look really flawless, then Laura Mercier would be the powder for you. Okay, so moving over to our more affordable drugstore products, the first one that I have is my trusty dusty Yardley Absolute Translucent Powder. And the Yardley Absolute Translucent Powder has been a powder that's been with me for years, literally since I started out with makeup. So it is a loose powder, it is a setting powder, and it is in the universal shade, which is the shade for all skin types. It does come in different shades, the powder, but I prefer the shade. In fact, I haven't tried any other shade because this has worked perfectly for me. Again, very smooth powder, very finely milled. It's really, really soft. I love how it feels on the skin, and I love that it does its job. It's really a great powder and comparable. I could literally put it side by side with maybe the Laura Mercier powder, maybe not Huda, because this one is not as, it doesn't provide as much coverage, but I could literally put it side by side maybe with a bit of Laura Mercier. It wouldn't give the exact effect which I would expect because Laura Mercier is more expensive, but it's a really, really great powder. Next powder is the She Glam Baked Glow Setting Powder. So this powder has a bit of glow particles in it, so I would say don't use a lot of it because you're going to get that reflective type of glow going on, and it might not necessarily be something that you're going for. This powder is a powder that I've reviewed. I do have a standalone video for this powder, and I absolutely love it. This is the powder that I was reaching for before I got the Huda Beauty powder. It is just that good, that good. I do say that per gram though, if you work it out per gram, the price per gram is kind of not as it's not as affordable as we'd like to think, but it's a really great powder. It does not give me flashback. I actually have a picture which I'll show you guys. It does not give me flashback. It goes really smooth on the skin. It blurs my skin out. And if you want to see more on that powder, do check out my video. I'm going to rate these powders in kind of in a category. So in terms of long wearing, I would say the Huda Beauty is the one that is the winner in that category in terms of blurring you out. I would also say Huda Beauty is first, and then the She Glam powder would be second. In terms of being comfortable and not too drying, I would say the Laura Mercier wins in that category. And of course, in terms of affordability and accessibility of the powder, Yardley Absolute Translucent Powder wins in that category. But all four of these powders are my absolute faves. So one tip that I want to give you guys that I think, once I picked up this tip, it was something that really changed my makeup game. One tip I want to give you is, after applying your cream product, so that is your cream foundation, your cream contour, your cream highlights, make sure that you are using a setting powder to set that before you go over with any other powder. So I know the habits that we get into, at least the habit that I was into, was to apply my cream product. So I apply my cream bronzer or my cream contour, for example, and right on top of that, because I love warmth, I go in with a bronzer. So a bronzer is not made to set makeup. A bronzer is a powder, and we can classify it as a finishing powder, but it is not made to set the makeup. So what would happen is, I would have my cream product, go in with my bronzer, my cream contour, go in with my bronzer, and at the end of the day, what I'd find is my bronzer would kind of move around throughout the day, and then this area and this section kind of as the day goes by, gets muddy because it melts, because that cream product is not set. So the pro tip that I want to give you guys is to set all your cream products. So what I do personally, I take a setting powder or translucent powder and I dust it all over my face once all of my creams are on. That is besides the under eye, because I go in with the setting powder. I take a translucent powder and I dust it lightly with a big fluffy brush all over my face to make sure that everything is set. And once everything is set, then only I go in with my contour, with my bronzer, with all my finishing powders, with my blushes, because those are basically finishing powders and not necessarily setting powders. So okay, so I'm gonna go into some questions that some of you babes sent through. And someone says, it makes my makeup a bit cakey, how can I minimize that? So if you have, like I said, your application is really, really important. If your makeup is coming out cakey, it's either you have a bad powder. So sometimes powders can be cakey. I know personally, the Makeup Revolution powder did that for me. It was very, very cakey. I didn't like it. Or sometimes it could be your application. So one, make sure that wherever you have powder, wherever you're applying powder, that your surface is fully blended, and the less product you have in that area, the better. So for example, your under eye is where you take the most powder, because you want to set your under eye nicely. So if your under eyes are maybe coming looking cakey, that means that one, you could have too much concealer on your under eye, or you could have a combination of foundation and concealer, which is very heavy under the eye, and then once you apply the powder, it becomes cakey, or you're placing too much powder in that area. So one, check out your technique on how you're applying it, and then two as well, make sure that you are using a really good powder. Again, someone is mentioning that their under eye looks really dry and textured after they set. One of the things that you can use to combat that are the tips from the previous question that I gave you, but also make sure that your under eye is very hydrated before you go in with your concealer and so on and so forth. Also, another tip that I can give you, avoid placing foundation directly under the eye, because your concealer is gonna go there. Avoid placing foundation there, because if you have foundation and concealer and powder on top of all of that, it can get a bit cakey. So just again, look at the tip, consider the tips of the previous question, but also make sure that your under eye is really hydrated with the under eye cream, or just taking some moisturizer, face moisturizer, and dabbing it under your eye. And the same goes for patchiness, because I see there's a question on patchiness. The same goes for patchiness. It could be patchy because your concealer is probably wet and thick, and when you place powder on top of that, I mean, if you're taking any flour on a wet surface, it gives that patchiness. Basically the same concept. Someone is asking what powder is best for dark skin. So if it's a really good powder, a translucent powder should be able to work for dark skin. But in the powders that I mentioned, the darker in the range, for example the Yardley Absolute translucent powder, the darker shades in the range I would recommend, because I have seen people using it and really liking it. Oh, here's a good one. Someone is saying, when I'm applying the powder, should my sponge be wet or dry? So my opinion, I would say your sponge should be damp. I don't want to use a dry sponge, because I don't want it to pick up on the concealer that I have already on my skin, and I don't want to absorb the concealer. And also I want it to be wet, because what happens with wet, with a wet substance mixed with powder, it becomes very cakey. So if you have a wet beauty blender and you're going in with it in powder and you're placing it on your face, you are definitely gonna get cakiness, you're gonna get cracking, and your under eye is not gonna look good. Okay, you guys, that's all I have for you for today. Hopefully you guys really, really learned a thing or two about powders in today's video. If you did, please let me know. If you like more educational videos like this one over here, I don't mind doing the research for you and coming back with all my findings, because that's essentially what I do. I don't know everything off the bat. I need to go do my research regarding these things. But I really do hope that you guys enjoyed this video, you learned a thing or two, and that you will be staying tuned for my next video. So thank you so much for tuning in. That's it, and I will see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to like, to comment, to subscribe, and to share. I'm really, really pleased to have you here, and I'm really thankful for you guys. Love and light to you and yours. I'll see you next time, babes. Bye.